For more than half a century, motor racing has drawn crowds in Japan. But for motorsports fans, one Grand Prix stands out, the 1964 meeting at Suzuka. It was the day the Skyline legend began. A team of Skyline GTs line up for the GT2 race. They were souped-up sedans, but were about to do the unthinkable and challenge the established champions from abroad. The Skylines nearly didn't get to the race at all. To qualify, 100 units of the production version of the car had to have been made. Prince Motors, later to merge with Nissan, only just made the target. The Skyline GT had a longer nose and a straight-six, triple-carburetted engine. It was the brainchild of chief engineer Shinichiro Sakurai. Reunited with the number 39 he drove in the race back in 1964, Yoshikazu Tsunako remembers the modified car seemed far from perfect at first.
ボディも、ここはちぎって20センチ伸ばしたような状態で来たわけじゃん。ね、だからあの、ボディとしてはものすごくバランスが悪かったわけじゃん。で、しかもタイヤが全然アウトだろ。だから結局、もうドリフトする以外は仕方がない、その格好になっちゃったわけだ。で、要するにそれがタイヤが滑ってくれるから、ボディの剛性も普通のままで良かったわけだ。
After a few practice runs, Tsunako knew the car was something special.
見事これが2分47秒っていうタイム出してるわけだから、だからあの当時は鈴鹿サーキットで一番速いのはこれだって威張ってたわけよ。
The saloon model Skyline would have to be quick. Another late addition to the field was a Porsche 904 Carrera GTS, a German car that came with a fearsome reputation. The Skyline would not defeat the Porsche, which could hit a top speed of over 250 kilometers per hour. But Tsunako's driver colleague, Tetsu Ikuzawa, would get ahead for a lap that all Japan would applaud.
Skyline GT got
As the Skyline led the Porsche, fans at Suzuka and around Japan went wild. The title ultimately went to the German car, but the Skylines had a clean sweep from second place to sixth. Tsunako was in the number two spot, and the plucky driving of Ikuzawa had captured a nation's imagination. Toshiyuki Shiga is now Nissan's chief operating officer. He says he decided on his path in life that day.
I was just 9 years old at that time, but I still remember that big news. So actually, 1964 is really starting Japan motorization, and always Nissan led initiative on the, these, you know, that the motorsport. I was so happy, and it was, you know, that kind of the, my children's dream. I want to enter the Nissan, you know?
Veteran race driver Kazuyoshi Hoshino, who himself would become a national hero at Daytona nearly 30 years later, said the Skyline also fired his imagination.
これが日本のモータースポーツの、やっぱきっかけだよね。もうこれしか頭になかった。僕がモータースポーツに入るそのきっかけはもうすべてこの54B
The Suzuka result in 1964 didn't produce a win, but it did inspire the development of the R380 series cars that would claim the Grand Prix over Porsche just 2 years later. And Tsunako would be at the wheel at the 1966 GP champion.
ポルチェに負けたのが悔しくてRシリーズができていったわけだから、そういう意味じゃ本当にあのポルチェの彼ら方が来たってことが素晴らしいことだったってことなんですよ。
Such is the significance of the number 39 that a team of volunteers have put hundreds of hours into restoring it. Working in Nissan's Zama Heritage Garage, where the car has been stored to make it ready to return to the scene of its greatest success, the Suzuka Racetrack. It was the racer that started the Skyline story, a legend that has continued through 12 generations of the car. Fitting memorial to the chief engineer Sakurai, who passed away last year, leaving a legacy of innovation and excitement that endures to this day.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.